Getting started with ATS130. Hello. Today, we will guide you through the installation, wiring, and commissioning of your ATS130. ATS130 can start and stop motors used in compressors, conveyors, pumps, fans. Unpacking. Unpack your ATS130 and verify that it has not been damaged. Scan the QR code in front of the soft starter to get your product data sheet and the technical documentation in digital format. Verify that the mains voltage value is compatible with the product. Mounting. The ATS130 can either be mounted in a cabinet using screws or using DIN rails. In this video, we will use an ATS130 N2D65LT. Screw mounting. With a screwdriver, pull out the fixing eyelets. Then mount the soft starter. Screw your soft starter onto the grid. Mounting on a DIN rail. Follow these steps to mount the ATS130 onto a DIN rail. Make sure to push on the tab to lock the product on the DIN rail. Multiple ATS130 soft starters can be mounted spaced out from one another, or can be mounted side by side with a reduction of the number of starts per hour. The product can be mounted with a T-SYS circuit breaker. If you want to do the assembly, you must use the fixing kit to put the soft starter and the circuit breaker together. Assemble the fixing kit and the circuit breaker. Check before assembling the circuit breaker and the ATS130 that the Everlink terminals are wide open. Assemble the soft starter and the circuit breaker. Tighten the Everlink terminals. To have more information about the mounting conditions, please refer to the ATS130 user manual. Wiring. The soft starter must be protected against motor short circuit and overload. The control part is supplied in 24 volts DC. ATS130 supports 2-wire or 3-wire control. Commissioning. Here is an example of an air-cooled chiller application. The soft starter allows the compressor of the air-cooled chiller to be started and stopped smoothly. Refer to the catalog for approved associations of circuit breaker or fuses. Set the motor overload protection at the rated motor current. In our example, we set the circuit breaker to 65 amps. According to our application, we first set the potentiometer start time to 20 seconds with a screwdriver. Secondly, we adjust the potentiometer initial voltage to 50%. Thirdly, we set the stop time to 0 seconds. When set to zero, the stop time acts as a freewheel. We then start the application by pressing the button S3. The ramp full voltage LED flashes yellow to indicate that the motor is ramping up. The ramp full voltage LED lights up yellow to indicate that the motor has reached its full voltage. Stop the application by pressing the button S4. Soft starter setup methodology. If the application needs a higher starting torque for a short time at the beginning of the ramp up, use the boost digital input by pressing S2. If the inertia is higher than expected, you can either increase initial voltage or increase start time. If the inertia is lower than expected, you can either decrease initial voltage or decrease start time. In case of abrupt stop, increase stop time. In case of too long stop, decrease stop time. Status LEDs and troubleshooting. The 24-volt main power LED flashes green when the control supply is present. The 24-volt main power LED lights up green when the control and the mains supplies are present. In case of errors detection, the ramp full voltage LED lights up red. Refer to the Status LED and Troubleshooting chapter of the ATS130 User Manual, PKR10053. Or scan the QR code in front of the product. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.